एक्स्ट्रा टाइम।
ভারতীয় শুটিং ফেডারেশনের সভাপতি, ইন্টারন্যাশনাল শুটিং স্পোর্টস ফেডারেশনের এক্সিকিউটিভ কমিটির সদস্য রণেন্দা সিং রয়েছেন তিনি এখন টোকিওতে। টোকিওতে শুটারদের ক্রমান্বয়ে ব্যর্থতা নতুন করে ভাবাচ্ছে শুটিং ফেডারেশনকে। যথেষ্ট আশা জাগিয়ে টোকিওতে এসেছিলেন সৌরভ চৌধুরী, মানু ভাকেররা। বিশেষ করে প্রথম রাউন্ডে অলিম্পিক রেকর্ড গড়ার পরে ফাইনালে ওঠার লড়াইয়ে এইভাবে হেরে যাওয়া কোনো মতেই মেনে নিতে পারছে না শুটিং ফেডারেশন। তবে রণেন্দা সিং মনে করিয়ে দিলেন, শুটারদের অধিকাংশের বয়স 19 বছর, সামনে পড়ে রয়েছে লম্বা ভবিষ্যৎ, আর এত কম বয়স হওয়ার জন্যই অলিম্পিকের নার্ভ ধরে রাখতে পারেনি তারা। কি বললেন তিনি সাংবাদিকদের মুখোমুখি হয়ে শুনে নিন।
There were no reports. There was only one person who was a negative factor in the whole thing, and I'll call it right now. You're referring to Jaspal Rana.
I'm not referring to anyone.
Then I'm referring to him. There was some before Croatia, not in Croatia. There was during the World Cup in Delhi and before that, a lot of internal wranglings in the pistol squad, in quote amongst coaches. That was addressed to all by me in person. In an 8-page letter I wrote to them prior to the team leaving for Croatia. And I think everybody respected that. Now, I cannot speak for individuals. We have honored all our coaches, all our ex-athletes, including Jaspal. It was I who brought him into the program. It is I who have supported him throughout. If for reasons best known to him and the athletes concerned, they are unable to work together. This is not China where we live, you know. I can't dictate that you will do this and you won't do that. They have to be willing to work with each other.
Ranender, is this true that, you know, when Manu and Jaspal weren't getting along and Manu sent him a message, he actually copied that message, put it on his t-shirt and was parading it on the range?
It was not t-shirt, it was a white shirt. Yes.
And that, was that true?
Yes.
And that merits disciplinary action, because you cannot demoralize an athlete like that. You're a former gold medalist of a major competition.
It was called out.
Was there any disciplinary action, or did you speak to the coach?
Disciplinary action, you see, please understand, when you're in a build-up to the Olympic Games, as the head of a family, you have to keep the peace.
And is this also true that you tried to get the two families together, Manu's family with Jaspal, and he started abusing the family? Is that true?
No, he didn't abuse the family.
What did he say?
But they didn't get on. Both of them didn't get on. It was not only Jaspal. The other side also was not willing to work with him. Because of various instances that they both cited. The girl cited something, the parents cited something, Jaspal in his defense cited something. I tried twice. This is once during the World Cup and once after. To put them together.
Go ahead.
If we look at the overall performance so far.
Yeah, but that this is not Jaspal's fault. Our performance here is not Jaspal's fault. I can't hold him responsible for this at all. I can certainly say it may have had an impact on Manu to some extent, because the second best thing I could do, in the whole of India, we have only one coach who can deal with a 10 meter and 25 meter athlete, and that is Ronak Pandit, because of his wife. Hina Sidhu was the same kind of an athlete, you know, in the same event. So that is the only thing we could do, and he very kindly came in and he's put in a brilliant effort, let me tell you. Don't let this 186 reflect on his effort. You saw the fight back she gave in the other event. So that's not it. Look, they are young kids, and one of them has failed.
So far in the last 2 years, 3 years, that Indian shooters have done well, those were largely events where top Chinese teams, top Korean teams, top Iranians and the Europeans were not there. So we kind of ek alag tarah se hum results view kar rahe the.
No, I think you have to understand that 2019, which was the last genuine year of competition, all the Chinese, Europeans, everybody was there. Pre-COVID, I'm talking about. And there we still topped it. Yes, I said in the World Cup in Delhi, I said this doesn't count. It's of no relevance. 32 medals is all fake, because most of them are in non-Olympic events. And secondly, there are hardly any teams there. This was for qualification by ranking. only people who had a chance in ranking came there. Everybody didn't have the kind of support that India and China have to send their athletes just like that for match practice. Some did come, some top guys. I wouldn't say that. I wouldn't say that 2019 was a very good year for us. We were number one in the world. And this is not...
লেটেস্ট নিউজ আর এক্সক্লুসিভ ভিডিওর সঙ্গে আপডেট থাকতে এখনই সাবস্ক্রাইব করুন আমাদের ইউটিউব চ্যানেল। বেল আইকনে ক্লিক করতে ভুলবেন না জানো।